Good evening, everyone. I welcome you all to the third and the concluding day of MDP on Marketing Analytics. I hope you all have done the assignment that was given to you on the second day of the MDP. Anybody who is interested to discuss and is willing to discuss the same can raise hand and we will allow them in the discussion.
Good evening to all participants. Anybody who has done the assignment, that will become a point of discussion. That person, that participant can click on the hand raise button and we will allow that participant to come in presentation room. Or else you can write in chat box. Yes, I'm again repeating, any participant who has done that assignment and wants to discuss the same can click on the hand raise button and we will allow that participant to come in presentation room and we'll discuss the same. Yes, if you have done your assignment, please write yes or no so that we can move further. There is a request from one of the participants. We received email yesterday and he is very much new into the job and he has requested that, ma'am, he has been told to do some project on customer analytics. So that is good. We can cover customer analytics also, though it was not in schedule, but yes, definitely it is part of marketing analytics on a very wide scale, I would say. So I will cover customer analytics considering the request of the participant. Though you can see that nobody changes the schedule, but this is a request which has been made by the participant. But before that, we would like to invite the participant who has completed the task, the assignment which was given, so that we can discuss on the assignment and brush up the topics once again. So, Professor Ghosh, can we continue with customer analytics, which was the request which was made by Karan? Karan is, I think, eagerly waiting, and it is, I think, a very good discussion.
I think Riya Khanna has mentioned yes.
Okay, fine. Yes, Riya, so, can be.
Riya, are you interested to join and present your, assignment so that we can discuss and make you people more informative that how it is being done, how betterly it can be done. Riya, if you were interested, you just raise your hand. There is a hand raise button.
Professor Ghosh, is Riya coming in the presentation room?
Yeah, she has raised her hand. So we already have asked her to please join.
Good.
Allow her. I think preparation time is going on.
Okay.
Riya, are you joining?
Is she joining?
Loud, but it is
She
taking
says
too much.
yes once again.
Haan,
she
she
says
said
yes in the chat.
Yeah.
Can you do one thing? Let me start that customer analysis, and by that time when Riya will join, then we can take her assignments and
let me put
forward.
Yes.
So,
I think I can start with the presentation. So, good evening once again to all the participants. This is one request which has come from the participant side. So you can understand how important it is that in his practical life, that means he's serving industry and he is very new to the industry and he has been asked to do customer analytics. The same thing happened with perceptual mapping also, that one of the student contacted me. Now it has been 3 to 4 years that he's into industry and he was told to do perceptual mapping and find out point of difference and point of parity. So customer analytics again is a very wider topic and part of marketing analytics. So I will throw some light on this because it is a request. So I cannot take it on a very elaborated way, but yes, at least I'll give you a nutshell that how you can do customer analytics. So what is customer analytics? It is the process companies use to capture and analyze customer data to make better decision. Now, when I'm talking about process which companies are adopting to capture and analyze customer data, now this customer data can be on their demographic, this customer data can be on certain individual determinants of consumer behavior like perception, attitude, learning, motivation. Then this customer data can be on the external determinants of consumer behavior. So you can understand that depending upon your requirement in the sense like what you want to capture. For example, my sales are declining. My sales are declining. Why? Because customers are leaving. What is the churning rate? What is the reason behind that at macro level or micro level? So you have to analyze the data. Fine. So why do companies use customer analytics? That is very important. Why they do use customer analytics? First thing is it helps businesses break big problems into manageable answers. See, you have wide variety of customers. For example, you have mass market. Quite often we talk about this, we do debate that mass market is alive or dead. But product like toothpaste, soaps, you have mass market and you have big problems into manageable answers. You really want to find manageable answers. You have to break these big problems. Then when companies need to look at how their customers behave, either as individuals or as overall, and then customer analytics, you decode that, their actions, how they are behaving. And it is very easy to understand. Otherwise, you keep on searching the information like that, jaise Hindi mein kehte hain ki us hiran ki tarah, jiske pet mein kasturi hai, lekin jungle mein ghoomta rehta hai ki khushbu kahan se aa rahi hai. Hana? Try to understand. So the same thing is applicable here. I mean, you really want to decode their actions, that why they are behaving like this. I'll tell you, on that day, I think Mr. Ahmed talked about Dove. I use Dove as a very good example when Hindustan Unilever said, कि मैंने क्या गलती कर दी अगर मैंने ट्रेडिंग अप कर दिया. आई गेव डव बिकॉज लक्स इज डूइंग वेरी वेल. इट इज ऑल्सो फ्रॉम द हाउस ऑफ हिंदुस्तान यूनिलीवर. बट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट एक माँ बाप के एक बच्चा दैट इज लक्स इज डूइंग वेरी वेल वेयर इज डव दे आर कीप ऑन आई मीन दे आर एक्चुअली प्रूविंग टिल डेट दे आर प्रूविंग एंड दे हैव डन ट्रेडिंग अप मीन्स यू हैव गिवन ऑल द सोप्स टू योर लोअर सेगमेंट यू हैव गिवन सोप्स टू योर मिडिल सेगमेंट बट यू हैव नॉट गिवन एनीथिंग टू अपर सेगमेंट एंड यू इंट्रोड्यूस डव एट अ वेरी कॉस्टली आई स्टिल रिमेंबर एट दैट टाइम इट वॉज मोर देन ₹45 एंड पीपल नेवर थॉट ऑफ एंड टिल डेट यू आर प्रूविंग दैट डव इज अ वेरी गुड सोप. So try to understand how these companies, they are decoding the actions of customers. Why? It is easy to understand what happened or what went wrong with which one of the P. Product is wrong, pricing is wrong, promotion is wrong, or else something else has to be looked out. I remember even Dabur hired McKinsey long back to find out that which brand is going to generate revenue for years and years. That was long back. I still remember in early 1990s where Dabur threw too much of money to McKinsey, and the only research problem which was posed to McKinsey was that tell me today all my brands are doing very good, but what will happen after 10 years or 15 years? Who will generate revenue? And it was told by McKinsey that Dabur Honey, Dabur Hajmola, Dabur Lal Tel, these are good product, these are good brands in your umbrella branding portfolio, retain them. These are few brands which you can leave. Why? Because they are not going to generate revenue in future. How it happened? Because of customer analytics, because they review the data, they decode the data because of action or behavior which they find in the market. Companies that use customer analytics comprehensively report outstripping their competition. Yes. If you keep on, seeing the taste and preference of your customer, you can really ahead with your competition in terms of profit almost twice as often as companies that do not do customer analytics. So you can understand why customer analytics is very important. Third thing is, how do customer analytics work? How it works? Customer analytics gives companies full visibility into how customers use their product. Now, it can be done at macro level and micro level. Macro, you know, it's a larger level. So what you do in macro level, you find out the trend of the users, how they are using it, how they are discovering their product, which features they are liking best, where they find value, and what causes them to leave. Even if they are leaving, what is the reason of leaving? At micro level, again, companies, what they are doing, customer analytics allow companies to understand who their users are as individuals. They can segment users by demographic. I told you in the beginning of my presentation, demographic is very important on the basis of interest and behavior. And then you find out journey. On 25th, I told you perceptual mapping is nothing but tracing your journey. Same thing is here. Customer analytics, you want to trace the journey of customer. So you have to do analytics. This can be at the micro level and macro level. Again, I told you, discover their how users are discovering your product. Features, what they are liking it, what kind of value. See, everyone is looking for value proposition. Kotler has talked about value proposition in his book also. You can find pages and pages. Today, we are not looking for anything else. We are looking for value proposition. And if we are not getting value proposition, definitely we'll switch to another brand. Fine. So both micro and macro level analysis has to be done. Now, this is a point of debate. Please understand practically, I told you that I have served the industry. Aaj se 10 saal pehle bhi wohi scenario tha, 20 saal pehle. Today also, we are finding the same scenario. Which teams have a need for customer analytics? Marketing people. Marketing people can create segments and look alike audiences. They cannot shed away their responsibility ki sales wala jaane. No. Marketing people, they create segments. Sometimes you have a very good product, but you don't know how to cater to which segment. आप वेजिटेरियन के आगे नॉन वेज रख दोगे, व्हाट विल हैपन? इट इज अ वेरी सिंपल एग्जांपल, बट लेट मी टेल यू द क्रक्स बिहाइंड कोटिंग दिस एग्जांपल इज दैट यू हैव टू क्रिएट द सेगमेंट्स, यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट व्हिच इज द मोस्ट सुटेबल सेगमेंट. फाइन, एंड लुक अलाइक ऑडियंसेस. यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल. ये तो लग रहा है मेरी सेगमेंट है, और पता चला वो लग रहा के पीछे भाग गए आप, बट एक्चुअली योर सेगमेंट इज समबडी एल्स. फाइन, सेल्स कैन स्कोर्स लीड प्रोस्पेक्ट एंड यूजर. सेल्स वाले कैसे यूज कर सकते हैं कस्टमर एनालिटिक्स? दे कैन फाइंड आउट लीड्स, दे कैन फाइंड आउट प्रोस्पेक्ट्स, दे कैन फाइंड आउट यूजर्स, एंड दे कैन एनालाइज देयर बिहेवियर, एंड दे कैन सबमिट दिस रिपोर्ट टू देयर डिपार्टमेंट्स. प्रोडक्ट कैन मेजर. नाउ दोज हु आर प्रोडक्ट मैनेजर्स, ब्रांड मैनेजर्स, दिस प्रोडक्ट इज अगेन अ टीम आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट. My topic is which team have a need for customer analytics. What these product managers can do with which feature a customer is looking for, which is the most important feature to be highlighted. What is the usage of the product and how it should be communicated to customers. And of course, again, how they are using it, trace their customer journey. Fine. Now, what questions can customer analytics answer? You have to be very careful. I am doing, whether it is marketing people, whether it is sales people, product manager, brand manager, regional sales manager, whatever designation and whatever position you want to take. Just think, give a view that what questions can customer analytics answer. First is acquisition. Which channel drive the most new customer? Kaise hatyaun? कैसे इसका वॉलेट, इसका वॉलेट मुझे ही खाली करवाना है, अदरवाइज नोबडी विल लाइक कस्टमर. वी ऑल आर सेइंग दैट हाउ विच चैनल, व्हाट शुड बी द वे दैट आई कैन ड्राइव द मोस्ट न्यू कस्टमर्स इन माय पोर्टफोलियो. व्हाट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन कस्टमर जर्नी फ्रॉम अवेयरनेस टू एडवोकेसी. यस, I'm looking for day one. We are talking about customer journey. Try to understand what most common customer journey I can look for, and I can find out if most of the customers are taking that journey. Well and good. Today, I'll just create an arbitrary example. See, this is an example which I'm not talking about positioning of Dettol today. For example, in coming months, if Dettol finds that the customer journey is changing and nobody wants Dettol as an antiseptic, they want Dettol for using in this mopping the floor, or maybe for washing the clothes so that I should be in a hygienic position and there should not be germs on my clothes. Now you can understand. And if the most common customer journey they see, Dettol people, they see that their customer journey is changing from antiseptic way to this particular thing, definitely they have to position and repositioning. That's we discuss. This is customer analytics, and now you do perceptual mapping. So how we are relating, everything is associated with one and another. Second is revenue. What are our most profitable revenue channels? Finally, you know, it is everyone is marketing. We say it is the only department which generates revenue. And among marketing, price is the only P which generates revenue. So I have to see what are the most profitable revenue channels. How I can analyze through customer. And which users are the most profitable? Again, I am running behind people who are switchers or maybe laggards. I don't want them because I have USP in my product and I'm running behind laggards. No, I have to hit home. Risk takers, innovators. हो सकता है इंडिया में सिर्फ 2% हो आपके प्रोडक्ट के लिए, आपके ब्रांड के लिए, लेकिन आप कम से कम बेनिफिट तो रीप करो. कैसे पता चलेगा? थ्रू कस्टमर एनालिटिक्स. कि व्हाट इज द मोस्ट प्रॉफिटेबल रेवेन्यू चैनल एंड विच यूजर्स आर द मोस्ट प्रॉफिटेबल. फाइन, व्हाट क्वेश्चंस अगेन कैन कस्टमर एनालिटिक आंसर? वन वॉज एक्विजिशन, अनदर वॉज रेवेन्यू, थर्ड इज रिटेंशन. आई विल टेक रिटेंशन का एग्जाम्पल. आई विल टेल यू हाउ रिटेंशन कैन बी डन. Now, where do we lose customers and why? Do you know losing one customer in marketing means us din matam chha jata hai company mein, jis din ek customer chala jaye. Because building one customer is very, very difficult. So where you lose customer, you have to see why we are losing customer. Kaun batayega? Customer analytics. Nobody will give you answer. You have to do a customer analytics to find that what is the reason that we are losing customers. What behaviors are correlated with high retention rates? Even if there are retentions, fine. What are the correlation? You have to see plus and minus. Jo plus hai, usko strength ke roop mein aap use karoge. Why? The reason is that you have to find out retention rates. It is known as retention analysis. See, I don't know. We have been telling you from day one that marketing analytics is very wide. Perceptual mapping is a small part. Customer analytics again is divided into so many things. So I have taken that retention analysis is again a part of customer analytics, and customer analytics is part of marketing analytics. Next is engagement. What features resonate with which customer? Itni bariki se dhyan rakhna hai. What features resonate with which customer? Tell me one thing. I just spoke to Subhiksha people. I just spoke to long back Subhiksha. So now it's not there in the market. I spoke to Reliance people. I spoke to many departmental store managers. And you know what they say? why we should give loyalty program to everyone. I said, how you define loyalty, sir? Jara mujhe bhi to bata do, aap loyalty kaise define karte ho? He said, ma'am, I'll tell you. And really, main to pakad ke baith jati hu, being a hardcore marketing woman, because I really want to know how loyalty is defined. Not that bookish language which is given in the books by Kotler or maybe Ramaswamy or Rajan Saxena or whatever. So how he defined, he said, ma'am, for example, daily one customer comes in our departmental store and he purchases 5 rupay ki cheez, 10 rupay ki cheez, ya nahi bhi kuch kharida, bas round laga kar chala gaya. Our loyalty programs are not for these kind of customers. Second kind of customers, they come in a week, let's say twice, and they spend near about 500 or something. Fine, but their visiting rate is that twice they come to our departmental store. Even our loyalty programs are not for them. They are not our loyal customers. And then he kept on defining, jo 3 din aa raha hai, 4 din aa raha hai, and finally said, ki ek aisa customer jo 15 din mein ek baar aaya, aur jab ne humne uski basket, jo usne kharida saman, uska worth dekha, it was 5,000 or maybe let's say 4,000, and we call them as loyal customers. So see, I'm coming to that slide. You have to define your retention definition. You are in the sense organizations. So if I talk about these departmental stores, they have easily defined their retention definition. Retention and loyalty means a customer who is coming only once in 15 days, but the worth of the basket is 3,000, 4,000, 5,000. वो नहीं जो रोज आता है और घूम के चला जाता है और 10 रुपए की चीज लेकर चला जाता है. सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल दैट हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू डिफाइन रिटेंशन. फाइन, देन एंगेजमेंट. आई एम टेलिंग यू, व्हेन आई फर्स्ट लर्न दिस वर्ड 2008-2009, इमोशनल एंगेजमेंट विद कस्टमर, आई वॉज शॉक टू लिसन दैट दिस वर्ड हैज कम इन मार्केटिंग बुक्स. यस, what features resonate with which customer and what is the optimal experience for users, aur wo tabhi mil sakta hai when you have emotional engagement with customer. And to find out emotional engagement with customer, you have to do customer analytics. Fine, now how to implement customer analytics? To implement customer analytics and derive useful insights, companies must do two things: capture, store, organize their data. These companies are big failure who never capture, or capture but don't store, or capture, store but don't organize their data. Then keep on searching for the information. Itna time to aapke paas pada hai, aapka competitor kahin aur nikal jayega. Today manager is saying, all marketing managers, they are saying, please don't bring these pages in front of us, we don't have time to read these pages, we only want crux and we want to just develop the strategy as against our competition. So this is not a very big thing for marketing managers, but the only thing is that they don't capture. Even if they capture, they don't store. Even if they store, they don't organize their data. And when you have done all these things, you analyze and make decision, because data is in front of you. You have facts and figures. Aise baat nahi karna, sales gir rahi hai, shayad ye hoga. Sales gir rahi hai, shayad ye ho sakta hai. No, no, no. You have to have proper data, do authenticity of that data, analyze and make decisions. Companies that do not properly maintain their data will have trouble getting straight answers. I told you, straight answer nahi milega. Atkale lagate reh jao, you keep on doing bhavishyavani, but you won't be able to find out the right answer. Customer analytics, don't talk about this. Don't have unstructured, stale data. 4 saal pehle, जब मेरी सेल्स गिरी थी तो शायद ऐसा हुआ था. नो, दैट हैपेंड 4 years बैक. टुडे यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट दैट डेटा शुड नॉट बी स्टेल. अनस्ट्रक्चर्ड डेटा इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. इनकम्प्लीट डेटा इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. इट मे लीड टू मिसलीडिंग रिजल्ट्स. एंड द की पॉइंट इज, companies that do not properly maintain their data will have trouble getting straight answers. This is the key point, key takeaway. Karan, you must be listening, because you had this request of customer analytics, that if data is stale, unstructured, incomplete, it may lead to misleading results. Now, one example, I should not say example, one part of customer analytics is retention rate. I've just taken, just to explain this, that how companies is following retention rate. A retention rate is the percentage of customer who are still with the company after a specified time period. then you call. I still remember when Professor Kotler was in India in 2005, if I'm not wrong, he said, "Maine bahut baat kar li. I have talked about customer satisfaction, but today the scenario has changed and now it is customer satisfaction plus customer retention." And the companies, they started defining their retention rates. So a retention rate is the percentage of customers who are still with the company after a specified time period. Each company should define retention rate. What is the period over which retention will be measured? Aisa nahi, aa jaye ek mahine tak bhi hai. Very good, we have got retention rate. No, you have to be very careful. Depends upon the kind of product, depends upon many other factors, and then you measure retention. How many actions within that time period constitutes retention? And when you keep on finding out, okay, this particular action, yes, today also he's doing. And, you know, 1 month back also, he visited our store and he bought the same product and worth was also same, 3,000, 4,000. And then you make benchmark retention and then you do analytics. This is one just small topic of customer analytics. That is retention analysis I've taken. That what is retention rate? Percentage of customers who are still with the company after a specified time period. Every company has to define the retention rate. What is the period over which retention will be measured? How many actions within that time period constitutes retention? And then you declare in the company, see, this is the benchmark retention. Now do analytics. And now we can define brand loyals also. And now how to benchmark retention? There are two ways for product teams to benchmark retention. Against themselves, against other companies. आपका रिजल्ट आता है अगर आपके पेरेंट्स, हमारे पेरेंट्स कहते थे, अरे ये तो पिछली आप ही की परफॉर्मेंस से, कंपेयरिंग योर परफॉर्मेंस इन लास्ट ईयर, दिस रिजल्ट इज डिटोरिएटिंग, सो दैट इज कंपैरिजन विद माय ओन रिजल्ट्स. दिस इज वन बेंचमार्क रिटेंशन. एंड द अदर वन इज अगेंस्ट योर कंपेटिटर्स. So you have to see, you measure against your own performance week after week, month after month. This is retention analysis. Aapko trend pata chal jayega, that reveals trend, that last week my retention rate of customer was this, or month, last month my retention rate. So you are comparing your analysis, your report with your previous report. That is, you are comparing with yourself. But if you are comparing with your competitors, I would say, then again it is retention analysis, but that requires again on a larger scale. You have to see, if you are market leader, don't waste your time, compare your retention analysis with your follower and challenger. If you are not market leader, you have a niche market, maybe 3-4 players or 5 players who are prevailing, who are top notch players in that particular market. So you have to see that what benchmark retention you want to make, and that you have to declare to your product team. I have mentioned that product teams, they must be aware. See, our benchmark retention is that last week we have gained this much of sales, why we are declining? Or our benchmark retention is that last week our competitor was here and we were here, and why we are declining, or why we are upgrading also. For positive also you have to find the reason, for negative also you have to find the reason. And I have written, if retention is trending down, the product team should be concerned and try to isolate the cause why retention is going down. Or if up, product team should try to isolate the correlated feature changes. Marketing campaigns, sir, we have done wonderful marketing campaign, that's why our retention is going up, and cohort behaviors that may have led it to capitalize on them. So if it is positive, again find out the reason. This is customer analytics. If it is negative, again find out the reason. So this is all customer analytics. You have to see very carefully that how you are going to judge the behavior of your customer. And when I say behavior of customer, even let me tell you, 55 lecture for the subject like consumer behavior are less for me, for every marketing professor, I would say. Because, you know, theoretical, you keep on talking about perception, learning, attitude, culture, motivation, and it is an endless story. So customer, and now see practically, I'm talking about theoretically, and now practically, when you have lakhs and lakhs of customers in the market, you can see how difficult it is customer analytics to go ahead with that. Fine. So I hope, Karan, any question, because this was all about from my side as far as customer analytics is concerned. Yes. You can write in the chat box if you have got your answer, or else if you have any question, I can explain that. Karan, you can write in the chat box if I have answered your query. I was very happy to see the mail from your side. At least we get motivation that participants are asking questions. So I just thought of preparing a small presentation for you. Any question? Professor Ghosh, can we have, okay, Karan has written, thank you ma'am for explanation. Yes, you're welcome Karan. So I hope I have cleared your doubt. You have my email ID. You can always keep on asking questions even if this MDP is over. That is not a problem. It is to all participants, you can raise questions and we will be very happy to help you out in analytics. Yes, Professor Ghosh. What next? Are we inviting Ria? Am I audible, Professor Ghosh? You're not audible. Kindly put your audio on. Neha, is Professor Ghosh is coming to explain that perceptual mapping template? Meanwhile, I'll take one question which has been raised by Dr. Rajesh S. Pingavil, that how the customer analytics is largely applicable in services. Very true, sir. I'll give you one example again created because being a marketing person, I then and there create an example. For example, hotel industry. I have planned a trip to, let's say, Manali or to Himachal or let's say to your place, Kerala. Fine. And being a customer, if I am not looking, a trend has changed and all the hoteliers or those who are into hotel industry, they have started realizing that people are looking for something different. Now, this people, I'm talking about customer. If they tempt me or they provide this kind of services that, ma'am, the surroundings of our hotel are very neat and clean. So what? That is not a tempting for me. If it is neat and clean, that is part and parcel of your services, I would say. Then probably they say that reception area is very beautiful. I don't have to do anything with your reception area. Fine. So then they say, okay, ma'am, our hotel rooms are very clean and we have white bed sheet and everything is very good. Okay, so go ahead. Next, ma'am, actually there is a TV and refrigerator in the room. So what? This is not a very, you know, potential or augmented service. But all of a sudden a line comes, ma'am, we have TV in washroom also. So this is augmented product. So that means they have started doing customer analytics that nowadays customers are looking for some augmented product. Fine. Are you getting what I'm saying? This is a very, again, humorous appeal I'm doing. See, try to understand. People are doing, this is one of the things, product managers, they are actually looking for what is augmented, what is required, and what is required can be judged only through customer analytics. As I told you, in case of hospital also, people have started doing analytics. See the COVID situation, all your hospital people, they are earning a lot and they are doing analytics. Fine, to find out what is required and what will help them to position their hotel in their mind that this is safe and here we are providing best COVID treatment. So again, I have given you services example, airlines. Airlines, if they do customer analytics and they're saying for 16 hours journey, they require some kind of entertainment and a guitarist on board. So how much time it takes, Dr. Rajesh, to hire a guitarist and place on your airlines on a plane to entertain the customers? These are very few small examples I have quoted to make the concept understand. So you can understand that, yes, I mean, customer analytics will tell you that what kind of requirement customer has, how he is discovering your product, how he is using your product, and how he is becoming brand loyal, or he is not at all becoming brand loyal. To bahut dur ki baat hai. His churn rate is, again, churning rate, you have to find out. He is leaving your brand. So how we can identify that, what really customers looking for? Sir, you have to carry out surveys. All your companies are giving. I'll tell you one very, very small example, then we'll switch over to Professor Ghosh because he wants to tell ki aap practically perceptual mapping kaise kar sakte hai. Yes, definitely I'll take your question, Dr. Rajesh. I participated in a survey where I was told, ma'am, we would like to close your eyes. And what you would like to have, a piece of cucumber or a glass of water? I said, what do you mean by this, piece of cucumber or a glass of water? They said, we just want to change the taste of your mouth. I said, better you give me a glass of water. And I said, what is the reason of closing my eyes? He said, if you are brand loyal, we don't want to show you product, that brand. If you are brand loyal, even if we remove the wrapper, you will recognize your brand. So we don't want to show that brand to you. Okay, they just offered a piece of cheese. That was cheese ka survey. I'll disclose. Being a marketing person, I was also very clever. Maine nikalwa liya ki kis kon ye research karwa raha hai. So they offered me piece of cheese and I had that cheese and there were near about, I still remember, 50 to 55 questions on that particular cheese. Then they told me, ma'am, just sit at a corner and we will call you after half an hour. After half an hour, again they called me, again they offered me a glass of water or piece of cucumber. Again I had a glass of water and then again they closed my eyes and I was offered again piece of cheese. But that cheese was very bitter. And I said, sir, shall I tell you who is conducting this survey? I said, the second cheese was from Britannia, because till date Britannia is not able to compete with Amul. And if I tell you people to write in chat box that which cheese you buy, definitely the answer will be Amul. So try to understand, you have to conduct survey. This particular survey was that Britannia wanted to know where lies the problem. And the problem was the taste was very bitter. So they got an indication that some formula has to be changed to make that cheese. And still, I don't think so that Britannia cheese is going doing good in the market. So I hope I have answered you this thing. You have to carry out qualitative and quantitative surveys, because in any case, you have to have empirical evidence, some data. Hana? Otherwise, I'm telling you, data cannot be. Thank you so much, Dr. Rajesh. Thank you so much for giving this remark. Nice explanation. These are my actually experiences I'm sharing with you people. I don't know what book says, but really, you have to conduct surveys to find out what customer is saying. Usse baat karo customer se. Tabhi customer batayega ki usko kya problem hai. Yes, Professor Ghosh, you can continue. Neha, is Professor Ghosh coming? Thank you, Rupali. Thank you so much. Really, one thing I would like to suggest also to my marketing friends, I would say, see, whether you are academician or you are into industry, let us feel proud that we have such a specialization which generates revenue. But let me tell you, this was just a statement which I passed. I am telling you, please participate in some surveys. involved in some research, then you will find that how customer is reacting. You may think different and customer may react in a different way. Please, I am always ready to help you people out. We can jointly do some research also. Fine. Yes, Professor Ghosh, are you ready? Your audio is not coming. Yes, yes, Dr. Ms. Rupali, experiencing learning is very much helpful. This is the reason that nowadays AICT and other people are also talking about that teachers should go to industry. See, I have due respect. I am into teaching profession since 20 years. But once you go into industry, let me tell you, we marketing people never see ki 16 page pe ya 17 page ke Kotler ne kya likha hai. We never see. It is, you know, we actually enumerate that what will be the next question of customer. We answer the present one and we actually manipulate that what he or she is going to ask as next question is concerned. Definitely, theory is totally different from practical marketing. Very different. Actually, we also thought of telling you how you can make perceptual maps once you have data. Professor Hello. Ghosh is going to explain. Yes, yes, you are audible, yeah. Sir. Now you are okay. Audible. Yeah.
Okay. So, good evening, everyone. I think for the last 2 days and today itself, Professor Gulati has explained a lot many things. Last day, we have discussed about perceptual mapping. Actually, Professor Gulati has explained those one. Today, I want to show you some tools available to us, which is very useful. And everyone can use this one. And you can easily develop any perceptual mapping. So let me share the screen. Here I am showing you a free template which is available for creating a perceptual map. Here you can see that this perceptual map is available and its detail is available in YouTube link also. If you click on www.perceptualmaps.com, you can get this particular website where from you can download this particular as a template. Now here, though it is a fast level idea, basically, those who used to start anything first time, how to develop perceptual map, for them, this is very helpful. And to do that, so very first one, you have to only see the blue colored boxes. There are different blue colored boxes which you have to fill up according to your requirement, and gradually you can get a perceptual map. Suppose here already a perceptual map has been prepared, which is for fast food market. The companies are McDonald's, Burger King, Wendy, In-N-Out, etc. Now I want to modify it for myself as auto market. So what should I do? In the step one, I have to modify this fast food into auto, and then you click anywhere else. You can see that in the perceptual map itself, the top level auto market has already come into picture. Now, Dr. Gulati has explained that there are two types of, I say, accesses over here, and these accesses starts from negative to positive, and y-axis are also from negative to positive. And you have to put certain idea about what should be the negativity and what should be the positivity that should be, mentioned through a particular keyword. Like here, it is junk food to healthy. Whereas in the y-axis, it is limited choice to wide choice. You can modify here the left side of the map, junk food. You can modify it as it is an auto market, that it is normal passenger vehicle. And on the other side, it is SUV, that is sports utility vehicle. Whereas in the y-axis, that is the vertical axis, bottom of the map, it is less cost to top high cost. Whenever I put these values in this blue, you can see that here already it has been modified as high cost, low cost, passenger vehicle, SUV. Now, here our attributes. So, in case of passenger vehicle towards SUV, we have to consider it within a range of 9-point scale, where 1 is passenger vehicle, 5 is the equal mix of both, and 9 is the SUV. This particular template has been developed in a 9-point scaling. So that is why whenever you will put or ask question through a online survey or through any other way, maybe offline or maybe pen and paper mode, so you must also have to create your scaling in a 9-point scaling. Now, here the company should not be McDonald's, Burger King. So here I put Tata, Mahindra, Maruti, Honda City. I add many other like Audi, BMW. So as soon as you will gradually use more number of, here you can take up till 25 different, I say, competitors. You can put over here because this template has been mechanized in that fashion. Now, suppose in a horizontal attribute, whether the Tata product is a passenger vehicle to SUV, how you will rate it? Suppose one customer has rated like it is more towards SUV and he has given its number 8. For Mahindra, it is suppose 7. For Maruti, it is 2. For Honda City, it is 9. For Audi, it is 9. For BMW, it is also 9. Now, if we see at the same time the vertical attributes, 1 is less cost, 5 is equal mix of both, and 9 is the high cost. Here, the competitive analysis is like that. Tata cost is very less. Mahindra cost is less. Maruti cost is, lesser. Then Honda City, cost is high. For Audi, it is 8. For BMW, it is 7, suppose. Now, here the size. What actually size is? Please note that this is an optional step. Basically, we can see over here some third attributes like market capturing, which is not a perceptual thing, which is already available from the data. Market capturing, we have seen out of 9, here the scaling is 5. So Tata has grabbed, I say 4, Mahindra 2, Maruti 5, Honda City 1, Audi 2, I say Audi also 1, and BMW 2. Now, after doing this, what basically you will see, if you go to the particular, I say perceptual mapping, just see what is the position. If we see that high cost and SUV is the plus plus side, here you can see that those who are in the plus plus side, but their market capturing is lower, whereas Maruti is not even a passenger vehicle, more towards a passenger vehicle, not a SUV, and its cost is less costly, and it grabs the market, the bigger, and this bigger market has been shown over here by the size of this particular ring. If you see the circle size, suppose I have changed the Maruti here, you can see the color of the Maruti and its size. If I can make a change over here, Maruti 5 to 1, what would be happened? Now you do understand that what actually that data used to show, that the market capturing which attributes may shown through its size, and obviously the perceptual mapping is like this. You can, after doing this, you can just make a click on the outside of this particular thing, take a copy, that is Control C, and you can put it at anywhere, even if you can take a Word file and you can show it in your Word file or presentation or anywhere else, which looks like this one. You can make it as per your requirement. Now, further to that, I can show you another speciality of this, that you can also modify this data accord, the presentation of this thing, because obviously for the marketing people, presentation is sometimes very much required. So that is why we can modify the presentation also. We can modify its area. So if you can like to change the, it would like this. So basically this is a template which has been created by www.perceptualmaps.com. They have their YouTube link to get the details how to create or how to do it by your own. And if you go to that particular site, you can also get different other things. I can also suggest you that what would be your this particular variables attributes. So to do that, let me move to this particular site. In this particular site, if you see, this is the www.perceptualmaps.com. If you see, there are different types of map procedure is there. Now, here are some ideas for how you can keep your attributes in your questionnaire or survey. The attributes should be like high quality to low quality, prestige to budget, friendly to aloof, strong taste to weak taste, broad choice, narrow choice. There are a good number of options they have given. So I can suggest you that if you can use this one, you may get a very good perceptual mapping without having much more knowledge or without you have to create much on this Excel. Basically, it has been done in Excel. You can also create all those Excel things if you want to develop this one. It is not very hard task. But yes, if you want to modify this particular template, you need a password because without password, you cannot modify the scaling. You cannot modify the yellow buttons. Only blue buttons you can enter the data and you can get the map. Let me have a look on the chat box that if you do have any question. For you people, now I am sharing this particular Excel file in the sharing. You can download here from this Excel file as we already have given in our files sharing. So I may ask the participants whether they do have any question on this particular perceptual map building template so that I can help them to further elaborate. Professor Gulati.
Yes, sir.
I think today there is no, reply from the participant side.
Riya actually did her assignment, mm-hmm. but I don't know what is the problem. She has written that she wants to come, but
yes,
Riya has written, yeah, ma'am, it's not accepting.
She could not join.
Yeah. Any participant?
And I think they do not have any question also on this issue. Whether they are there or not, we do not understand. There is no, I say, reply from the other side.
Yes.
Okay. Already shared.
Priya is writing, we are there, sir. Yes, yes, Priya, we can understand. Actually, we really want to discuss that at least one presenter should come in the presentation room and discuss the assignment. Yes, they have got the file. So you are not audible, Professor Ghosh. Your voice is not coming.
Yeah, now it is now, fine.
Yes, sir.
Whether you have any question to run this thing, you can write on the chat box. Ma'am, otherwise we can do another thing. There is another particular very, I say, important thing. Which we can show, that is the brand association.
Brand association is very important. Yes.
It is also
absolutely.
It is also a template based, Excel template based. Ma'am and sir, can I send you my assignment?
Yes,
Riya, you can send it. We will obviously inform you back that how it can be developed. So, dear participants, like this perceptual map, there is another very easy, simple, I say template, which is brand association. But to run this particular template, you should have to download okay, sir, thank you. Okay. This is another template which is for create your own brand association map. But to do this, mind it, your system should have an add-on which is known as Solver. If you do not have Solver, you cannot get this particular mapping. Now, how to add Solver? That was also given in this particular, I say, Excel, in another sheet. Here also I am first sharing you this particular template so that you can also make a hands-on along with us. So I am sharing the brand association also. You can download it. If you have Solver, you can run it with me. If you do not have Solver, the process has been mentioned over there. It is very easy. Just click on it and you can get the Solver part too. So, this is, I think, from Solver part. It can be shared from entire screen share and here. Here you can see what actually brand association is. Now, while you are developing a brand association, this will come into this particular graphical map. And first you have to give a title of your map. Suppose I am giving a title like brand association of, once again it may be taken as I say soft drinks, soft aerated drinks, and I am doing this on behalf of, suppose, Coke. So what I am doing? Brand association of soft aerated drinks, and my brand name is Coke. While I put these two values in this blue area, if you go into the lower part, you can see it has already become brand association of soft aerated drinks, and Coke is already mentioned over there. Now, while I put Coke over here, you can see automatically in the step 3, in number 1 column in the yellow, Coke has already come. That means you are comparing Coke in different attributes or associations or segments or any other differences. We can do it like this: Coke, Pepsi, Bijli Grill, then but if I put Fruity over here, you can see what will be happen. Fruity is not an aerated drink. We have to consider all the aerated drinks. So I can take any other name, ma'am, you will suggest? 7 up. I already added 777. Let me make 7 up.
Limca you can take.
7 up.
Sprite.
Limca. Sprite. Miranda. Here we have a choice of up to 12. This total has been mentioned in such a way that up to 12 attributes you can compare. Anything more?
Pepsi, 7 up, thumbs up, Limca, Sprite, Fanta.
Fanta. A new drink has come, Prawn. Is a Bangladeshi company, they have started marketing in our country. Oro. And main ek local brand de diya hum log ka ye jo soda hai hota hai.
Karan is writing Appy Fizz. Okay, fine. Appy Fizz.
Chalo. Appy piece. Le liya. Now, if you see, while I put all those 12, I say, attributes or associations over here, automatically in the step 4, you can see a comparison has started. It has automatically created. Coke versus Pepsi, Coke versus Bisley Grill, Coke versus 7-Up. Similarly, Pepsi versus Bisley Grill. Now, here are the comparison is like, one means virtually the same, two means quite similar, three means reasonably similar, four is somewhat similar, five is neither, six is somewhat dissimilar, seven is reasonably dissimilar, eight is quite dissimilar, nine is virtually opposite. So if we see Coke and Pepsi, it is basically virtually opposite group, because one is black group, another is, I say, other than black group. So I can say 7. Then Coke versus Bisley Grill, it is also dissimilar, and it is but in the sweetener it is more towards that, so it should be 6. Then Coke versus 7-Up, it is also 6, 7, 8 range. But Coke versus Thumbs Up, they are in the similar group. So virtually the same, quite similar, reasonably similar. I can say it is quite similar. Then Coke versus Limca. So now I am giving all the marking in my own way. There is no meaning. I am not using my brain. Just I am giving some value over here, because I have to complete all these, I say, verticals to get a final result. So that is why, to do all those things, let me start with our student theory. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I have seen my student, he used to fill up their, I say, when they got their friends request that today I need to fill up 100, I say, online data, please fill up something. So they do like this. So here also I am doing the same. Just copy it, put it over here, copy it, put it over here. Though I know that it do not have any meaning, but still, to complete the thing, I have showing you how it actually works. And then you are to click in this box. While you click in this box, they're showing that macro is not running. So I have allowed macro. Okay. And it has started working. And you can see the brand association of soft aerated drinks with Coke. Now, if you see, Coke is very similarly associated with Thumbs Up. But it is the lowest association with Happy Fizz. Karan ne jo bataya tha. I don't know whether this data, though it has been given in a whimsical manner, you can put it in your own way and you can check that how betterly you can represent the brand association of a particular brand, where it is, you can also modify the brand like this. You just click on a brand and give it like this. And all the others in different colors. We can copy it, just click outside, Control C, and the last way what we have shown, make a Control V, your brand association is here. Now,
I think, Professor Ghosh, this can come out to be a very good research paper. I mean, we people
It's
a very important topic, brand association. Right. I mean,
Now, if we come back to the way Now, how you will do this? Because it is the last part. I say only to show the map. This is the way you can do it. But how you will collect the data? You have to develop or generate a questionnaire. And in that questionnaire, you can make, yesterday, I think day before yesterday, Dr. Gulati has already informed that comparison, comparative scaling, different scaling techniques are there. Here it is basically a scaling technique. Coke versus Pepsi, Coke versus Bijli Grill, Coke versus 7M. These are all semantic differential scale. You can use that scale also over here. You can also use the comparison between every two such matters. Here we have modified, if we modify this in some other way. Suppose I want to verify Coke with some of its attributes. मैं पेप्स ये सारे ब्रांड को हटाता हूं. लेट मी चेंज दिस वन. यू जस्ट सी हाउ द रिसर्च विल मॉडिफाई. नाउ कोक फर्स्ट इज टेस्ट, सेकेंड इज इट्स एरेशन, दैट इज कार्बोनेटेड. एज इट इज अ कार्बोनेटेड ड्रिंक, इट्स कार्बन इफेक्ट. आई से CO2 इफेक्ट, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इफेक्ट, CO2 इफेक्ट. देन स्वीट, हाउ स्वीट इट इज. देन यू कैन ऑल्सो चेक इट्स आई से वेरियंट्स. You can check. Now I am showing here only five different attributes of Coke, and it is I say healthy. On these five attributes, while I put the value, first I have to delete all those things which I have put previously. Because here if you see that all the white points are not filled up. So you only put the value in those filled up columns. Means Coke and taste. If you feel, is it a very tasty? So you can put it one. And if you say, sir, it is tasty, but not so tasty that I have seen or taste in, I say, thumbs up. So, you can give a value of 3. CO2 effect. Sir, CO2 effect to sabse jyada mere ko lag raha hai wo carbonated drinks dete hai. Coke nahi dete hai. So, it is not virtually opposite, but it is somewhat similar, so I am giving it a 4. Then Coke sweet. Obviously, Coke is very sweet. That is one of the main point of Coke. Then Coke variants. How many Coke variants are available? I say whether any other variants have more variants than Coke, any other brand. If not, then I will put it is the 1. That Coke have at least Diet Coke, so it has a variant. But thumbs up do not have such variant. Whether Coke is healthy or not, here also I have to compare Coke with other brand, and I can give my opinion that yes, it is around 3. Then taste versus CO2 effect. Now you see. If I consider the taste of Coke versus its CO2 effect, should I put something else or I should put this one at the top? If I put the taste versus CO2 effect is best in case of CO2, Coke, then I put it 1. If not, I put it 2 or else 3 as per my brand I say preference. In the same way, taste versus sweet, I can give it again one. Then taste versus variant, I can give it one. Taste versus healthy, giving it six. CO2 effect versus sweet, it is three. CO2 effect versus variants, it is four. CO2 effect versus healthy, it is also less. Sweet versus variant, is there any other sweet variants who have much more variant than Coke? I say maybe, so it is two. Sweet versus healthy, it is three. Now, what I am doing, it is as a, I say, I am a subject. I am answering according to my own perception. Similarly, I have given this particular, I say, questionnaire to 200 people, 500 people, and everybody has filled it up. Now, what I have to do, the Coke versus taste column, I add it up for all the 200 people and divided it by 200. And that value comes to something else like 3.45. So it will not take 4.5. So it has taken as 3.5. Similarly, for CO2 effect, it comes around 6.5. Coke versus sweet, it comes around 1.9. Coke versus variant, it comes to 0.6. But it will not take any value below 1, mind it. So that is why it says like that less than 1 is not applicable. So I have to put 1.1. Yes, it will be taken. So in this way, once you modify and you go back to your brand association of soft aerated disc, here I modify the title. Brand association of Coke attributes. And you can see it would like this, that the particular brand is have very close relation, very close association with variants. It has quite positive association with CO2 effect, less association with sweetener effect. Its healthy factor is also negative, and I say less. Taste is also, I say, not preferred by the all the subjects who have given you these responses. So in this way, we can create our research activity for the people who are working in their day-to-day life. They also have to create this type of presentation, because they have to prove that how their own company or own product either better or worse than the other. So if you do like this, this particular template helps you a lot. Once again, let me stop the presentation. This template. Can anyone have any question or points to be discussed?
Yes, participants, you can raise questions.
I also suggest you the website that I have shown to you and which is mentioned in this particular template. You can use those particular website. There are numerous such template features which you need not require to build up. Many of the times, many of the newcomer in the industry do not have the time to create or generate this type of templates. So this is a free downloadable template available. You can go through that website and you can use that particular templates. To understand those, there are YouTube links. You can go through it. I have shared you two such because nowadays you are also thinking that the basic concept has been given. How I can use it? So I have shown you two such effective way how you can run some data which we call analytical data, convert it into a decision making process. On the very first day while I have started with, I mentioned you that marketing analytics is nothing but a concept of using some data to take certain decision in the field of marketing. In these 3 days, we have informed you some of the marketing activities. And in those activities, with the help of analytics, you can find out that how you can take a solid decision. Many of the times, the manager, particularly marketing managers, are answerable while there is no result out of a decision taking during a brand promotion or any other activity. But if this type of supporting documents is available before a manager, they can explain that on which basis you have taken this decision. You can present it before your top management and it is easy for you to convince them that how you come to a conclusion like this one. I think Professor Gulati, there is no such question. Mm-hmm, and mm-hmm. The assignment is also not there. Mm-hmm. So let we come to a concluding part.
Yes, sir.
After audio is...
Neha, your audio is not coming proper. I mean, it's low.
Hello.
Hello.
Can you hear me?
Professor Ghosh, there is a question from Rupali ma'am.
Or we have to do pilot study. Ma'am, basically this template has been developed on 1-to-9 scale. Now, if you are targeting for 5-point scale, 7-point scale, or any other type of Likert scale, basically what we do understand, then you can modify the template, but for you can generate the template also. It is very easy. In Excel, it is very easy to understand and you can develop also. Even if you want to change, you can take a permission from this particular website which I have been given. They will permit you to modify that particular scaling. And based upon that, you can mention that what you require.
Hello.
Yes, yes.
Am I audible?
Yeah.
Okay. I was thanking Ghosh sir. Thank you so much, sir, for enlightening our participants with use of such a powerful tool to build perceptual map. It gives a new direction to perform market research for a variety of purposes. I also extend my gratitude to Professor Uma Gulati for explaining the concept of service analytics and taking up our participants' query. I would also like to request all the participants to fill up the feedback form, which will be shared shortly with them over the email. Once again, on behalf of Geetharthan International Business School, thanks to all the participants for attending the MDP on Marketing Analytics. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Neha.
Thank you.
Thank you to all participants. Thank you so much.